The Fed came to the rescue of the markets today with their massive forward guidance across multiple avenues. In fact, there were 13 separate Fed events in 1 week to help this weakness turn around. Realistically, we are looking at a time in which the stock market is 100% completely reliant on extremely easy monetary policies, and it can't be denied any longer. You came here for the truth, so let me unveil that for you. Stock markets around the world performed extremely well today. We're going to look at exactly what happened, then I'm going to show you why. There's a lot of detail in this video. I'm going to move through it quickly. Let's begin. Here you can see all of the green on the right-hand side, the S&P 500, the NASDAQ, the Dow Jones was up over 500 points on the day, and that connects in with the Asia markets that are performing very well at this time. What we are looking at right now is obviously a big change from the last few days where the market was starting to feel the pain of all the tariff issues, of all of the Federal Reserve concerns that has been turned around yet again. The market needs this periodically in order to continue the boom that's going on. Not only do they need to print excessive amounts of money all around the world, not only do they need to keep interest rates at extremely low levels, they need to constantly and persistently send the message out to the public telling them that everything is going to be just fine. They're there. The S&P 500 came back above its 200-day moving average, which is obviously very important for traders and the algorithms that are looking at this information and trading based on it. So I just wanted to show you that in terms of the technicals. Looking at this, a short squeeze happened, and you can see exactly why the stocks came up. Financials did come up quite a bit, but they seem to be meeting with resistance from last week. So we'll see if they can continue this trend. I'm going to watch the markets obviously very closely as long as the Federal Reserve is there to make sure that everybody is tucked in at night. This will, of course, continue to go higher. Right now at this time, we are seeing that the FOMC is expected to cut rates right now. I believe it's 89.9%. As you can see here, the orange line, that's what they predict to occur. Go back to September, October timeframe, and it was the same thing, except that was the probability of a hike, not a cut. So we've gone complete 180 at this time. And if you remember back in the September timeframe, they were saying that this market was doing so well. There's never a concern. You don't have to worry about anything. The Federal Reserve is going to continue their balance sheet wind off, and it's going to happen at a very, very slow pace. Nothing to worry about there. The Federal Reserve can increase interest rates at a very slow pace, and that's not a concern either. And then October came and everything changed. And obviously, that continued on throughout December. The market started to cry very, very badly. And today we are at a point in which the expectation is multiple cuts in 2019. And that would have to be basically every meeting they have at this point, they want them to cut. So we'll see if they actually do it. It's coming up not too long in the future. So we'll see how they actually do move on interest rates. This is really the big news of the day. Powell says that the Fed will, quote, act as appropriate to sustain the expansion. So obviously this means don't worry about it. We're going to take care of it. This could mean any one of the obvious, whether we have rate cuts, whether we have more money printing, whether they do some sort of operation twist. It doesn't matter. Ultimately, the Federal Reserve is going to be there to backstop the losses. That's what they're telling the public. There's more detail in here. Actually, there's so much that I want to make a video about it in particular, so I'm not going to cover that specifically. I wanted to show you the other examples. You can see the Chicago Fed president also having an interview here. In this interview, I just watched the clip of it, and basically they're suggesting here, you don't have to worry because we're looking at all the data at this time. Everything looks okay. In the event that something changes, we're going to act. Okay, that was another one. And then we have this. The Fed vice chairman also said, I do think you have to look at the yield curve. I think historically a flat yield curve doesn't convey a lot of information. If the yield curve inverts as it has, and if it persists for some time, that's obviously something I would definitely take seriously. So that's what they're talking about in this case. Essentially, what is going to make you react and start to actually do something about what we are fearing at this time? Yes, they're going to decrease the interest rates, they are going to print more money. It is only a matter of time. Northman Trader actually had some good information up on his Twitter that I needed to share with you. Quote, "If you don't think 13 Fed speakers in 1 week don't find a way to rally this market, you haven't been paying attention the last 10 years." Very good point, because you've seen it yourself. We are looking at this market right now today in which it is entirely dependent on easy money. And it's not as if we printed money back in 2009, 2000 2010 and beyond, and that is the money that was it. No, this is a continuation that we are seeing today with the extremely low interest rates, with the balance sheet still above $3.5 trillion. They won't let it go anywhere below this level. They are already starting to talk about tapering it off. It's only a couple months away. And here we are today worrying, begging, and pleading with the Federal Reserve to cut interest rates, to give them some slack because the market is weak. This is acknowledging that there is a problem. We need to understand that. If the Federal Reserve actually does decrease interest rates, we have to acknowledge, yes, there is a problem. The Incredible Adventures of Jay Powell, Fed Chair. Check this out. October, balance sheet on autopilot, rate hikes in 2019. December, oh my goodness. January, flexible on balance sheet and patient. March, end balance sheet roll-off and no rate hikes until 2020. June, we are ready to act. Can you believe this? How quickly things change. We were looking at a time in which everything was just fine. We had Goldilocks. We had all this garbage that they kept on talking about. And now today, they are basically changing their stance entirely, ready to act. I don't know on what information exactly, because according to their PCE, inflation will never go higher as far as I'm concerned. So they're not going to cut rates based on that. They're going to make up some other excuse. And of course, we'll see some information that comes up later on from their meeting minutes. We're going to read through it. I'm going to get that for you. But ultimately, it is just sad and sorry to read this kind of garbage that they put out into the media, and the public doesn't really care. All they care about are their 7 shares of Amazon. Stanley Druckenmiller sold everything and bought treasuries after the threats on China. Now, you have to understand who Druckenmiller is. I've seen criticisms of this individual here, but it's funny because he has perhaps the best record ever known in terms of his investing. Okay, that is documented facts. Most people, they think they're high and mighty because they've been investing for the last 4 years. This is an individual that put himself out there, and now everything has changed for him. So when the threats started to happen with all the tariffs and everything else, he said, "I went from 93% invested in net flat and bought a bunch of treasuries. Not because I'm trying to make money. I just don't want to play in this environment." So he's basically just walking away from it, saying, "Everything is messed up. I am getting the hell out." Here's a little bit of positive information, but actually the underlying part of it isn't so good. But regardless, CVS to open 1,500 health hub stores over the next 2 years. There's some info in here that I need to get to. Number one, 1,500 new stores opening is very positive to the economy. Economically, this is good news. Number two is that they say they are redesigning CVS stores. Now, if they're going to redesign it, are they necessarily opening a new location and employing new people? That is information I'm uncertain of at this time. Number three is that they're suggesting 1,500. We'll see what the actual number is. Okay, I will obviously bring that to you. I also wanted to mention the fact that these health hub stores are basically like half of a clinic and half of a drugstore, okay? So just wanted to clear that up. And my final point is basically that we are looking at this industry, unfortunately, the way it is, that this happens to be a booming industry. Many people are sick. Many people are dealing with issues, health complications, one way, shape, or form, that this happens to be one very booming industry. So again, economically good, but the underlying problems there aren't so good. That's all for this video. If you found it informative, please give me a thumbs up. When you give me a like on this video, you're supporting me and this channel, so I do appreciate that very much. If you want the financial education you were not taught in school, these two books have everything you need from top to bottom, A to Z. You can get all the details at the link in the description. I'm going to show you everything you need to know all about the financial system. Check it out at the link in that description. If you want the audiobook that's available at themoneygps.com. The economy is definitely unraveling and you need to be aware of the information. Definitely click on this video and I will see you there.